3 o'clock in the morning. So right now I am panicking slightly, because tomorrow I have 2 tests, a lot of homework to get in, plus the Mario movie. We may be wearing tuxedos. I think that would be kind of funny, but after the whole like Minions thing, people were wearing like suits to go to that. Like a bunch of those kids were like rioting in the theaters or something. So a bunch of theaters would like turn you around during that trend if you had like a suit on. Let's see how it turns out, shall we? I tried not to, but I searched up the reviews for the Mario movie. they're not looking so great. Audience scores are always a little bit different from critics, but I think what I was checking was the critic score. And the critic score on Rotten Tomatoes, at least, was a 55. Ouch. Alright, so we've showered and we're getting ready for the day, and now it is time to do my hairstyle that I've done for the past, every single day for the past 6 or 7 years now. So, we're ready for the day, and we're about to drive off. I was not able to finish my math homework, so that might be a problem, and I am nowhere near ready for my test today. That is a big issue. Okay, so we're out of school now, and we're at the movie theater right now. We're ready to see the Mario movie.
Mario!
Yes, that was quite the enriching theater-going experience, if I do have to say so myself. I feel really weird standing here without holding my microphone. Overall, I'd say the movie was fantastic. If you are not a Mario fan, then the movie was probably very painfully mid. Without giving too many spoilers away, one issue I did have is that the pacing for the movie was so strange. Like, I left that theater and it felt like maybe 50 minutes had passed. Maybe even 30. Like, I left that theater and I thought maybe like 30 minutes had passed. That movie felt so short. It went from scene, 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 scene. All the references were very cool. There were so many in every single shot. It felt like the movie was trying to show you this. Hey, look at this. Do you remember this? Do you remember this? Okay, now look at this. Do you remember this? Okay, now look at this. Do you remember this? It was in an every single shot. It got kind of ridiculous. But I did really enjoy it. Some of the examples I remembered was there was a pizza restaurant called Punch Out Pizza, and it had pictures of the Punch Out characters in there. And the music incorporated the game music beautifully. It made little tunes that made sense in the game, and it orchestrated them into these grand pieces. For example, there was a spooky forest, and in the background you heard the little Luigi's Mansion. Doot 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 doot. Almost had a heart attack. That was so wonderful. It was a nice touch. I appreciated it. I am recording, right? And to be honest, I thought wearing these tuxedos to the movie would be kind of, would be pretty unique and funny. Turns out it was neither. Because we walked in, and honestly, okay, so we went on opening day, and honestly, everybody showed us up. There was more people in suits than there was people not in suits. For example, there was this one group of people, there was one Princess Peach in the middle, and all of the other men around her were people in suits, and they were wearing Mario hats. And they were like surrounding her, protecting her as bodyguards. So we did get showed up a little bit, but that doesn't mean that we lost our class. We were still very classy, clapped for the movie like this. But you know who enjoyed the movie more than I did? In conclusion, if you're a Mario fan, why have you not seen the movie yet? Go watch the movie. I promise you, you'll love it. If you're not a Mario fan, maybe wait to rent it on TV. So, thank you for tuning in, folks. I shall see you tomorrow. I shall see you till we meet again.